Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm going to do a tribute reaction, man. A tribute reaction to the late, great Kenny Rogers. I learned of Kenny's passing last night. And sorry that this is coming a little bit on the late side. I didn't have a chance to get to it until now. This is first thing in the morning on the West Coast. Yeah, I got a message from one of my longtime subscribers, Al Petreni. Al, thank you, man. Al has sent me a link to his favorite song by Kenny. Kenny is his favorite artist, and he's also the song The Gambler is also his favorite song. So he asked me if I could please do a tribute reaction to Kenny, and certainly, Al, I will for sure, man. So let's get this on. Kenny Rogers, The Gambler. I have a lot to say about this man. Even though I was brought up in R&B, this is one of those people who's crossed genres and has always been around. All right. The Gambler, Kenny Rogers. Let's get it.
On a warm summer's eve, on a train bound for nowhere, I met up with a gambler. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns of staring out the window at the darkness till boredom overtook us. And he began to speak. He said, "Son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces and knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind my saying, I can see you're out of aces. For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice." So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow. Then he bombed a cigarette and asked me for a light. And the night got deathly quiet, and his face lost all expression. Said, "If you're gonna play the game, boy, you gotta learn to play it right. You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done." Every gambler knows that the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep. 'Cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser, and the best that you can hope for is to die in your sleep. And when he finished speaking, he turned back toward the window, crushed out his cigarette, faded off to sleep. And somewhere in the darkness, the gambler, he broke even. But in his final words, I found an ace that I could keep. You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. Be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold, when to hold, know when to fold, know when to fold, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough to count when the deal is done."
Excellent. takes us back to a time when music videos wasn't a whole bunch of flash and grandeur. It was just a nice, distinguished gent sitting there looking at the camera and just addressing what he's got to address. No frills or gimmicks or anything else required. Fantastic. Yo, man. Kenny Rogers. This dude has been there, an ever-present personality in my growing up. I haven't been raised on the genre of country or rock or whatnot, but, you know, he is one of those artists that has a great crossing over effect. And it's to the point where I could sing this song word for word, you know, from the time it came out all the way till now. Now that is some serious social and cultural impact, let me tell you, man. And the first impression or the first exposure I had to Kenny Rogers was The Gambler. It was the song and then the movie. No one, you know, being around my age and the Muppet Show was all the craze back then, it wasn't his rendition of The Gambler on The Muppet Show. It was actually just sitting there and listening to a playlist that my mom had when she had a couple of her girlfriends over. My mom was really big into the Tupperware thing, and she had a whole bunch of her girlfriends over. And it was summer break, and I had nothing else to do. The pool was closed for scheduled cleaning, and my best buddy Craig was away up in the cottage, so I was bored out of my damn mind. So I was kind of like playing assistant host to my mom's Tupperware party, you know, bringing the lemonade, the refreshments. This song was playing, and she played it over and over again, and it got to the point where I knew that song word for word, man. And finally, I got a visual of who was singing this song, perfectly fitting, you know. And then I learned thereafter that there was a film and everything. Really enjoyed the hell out of the movie. I remember that. So my parents really, really liked Kenny Rogers, especially my mom. And my dad right now, my mom has passed. My dad right now is very upset about that. And even though he's an old blues man, old reggae man, that sort of thing, like I said, Kenny's influence crossed genres, man. And he had the ability to influence and affect everybody around him where it comes to his music, where it comes to the contemporary of what was happening. Yo, man, I'm telling you, this is a great, great loss for the world of music and entertainment, but a great ambassador all the same. I believe he was 81 when he passed, so he might have passed of natural causes. So we'll take a look at that. I'm just bringing up the Wikipedia page as well here. okay. Yeah, okay. There we are. So, yeah, let's do a little background on this great, great man, man, and get an idea for how he lived and how he passed. Yeah, so Wikipedia, okay, Wikipedia is saying that it needs more citation because some information is not available. Okay, what they're talking about is circumstances around his death. They still are not quite sure. They believe it to be natural causes, but not quite sure. Nothing has been officially released. Okay, so well, let's start from the top. Let's get a little background on Kenny, man. So, Kenny Rogers, 1938 to 2020. Kenny Ray Rogers was an American singer-songwriter, actor, record producer, and entrepreneur. He was elected to the Country Music Hall of Fame in 2013. Rogers was particularly popular with country audiences, but also charted more than 120 hit singles across various music genres, and topped the country and pop album charts for more than 200 individual weeks in the U.S. alone. He sold over 100 million records worldwide during his lifetime, making him one of the best-selling music artists of all time. Okay. Yeah, so a little background, a little history. In the late 50s, he started his recording career with the Houston-based group The Scholars, who first released The Poor Little Doggy. After some solo releases, including 1958's That Crazy Feeling, Rogers then joined the group with the jazz singer Bobby Doyle. In 66, he became a member of the folk ensemble The New Christy Mentrals, playing double bass and bass guitar, as well as singing. In 67, he and several members of The New Christy Mentrals left to found the group The First Edition, with whom he scored his first major hit, Just Dropped In, to see what condition my condition was in. A psychedelic rock song, which peaked at number 5 on the Billboard charts. As Rogers took an increased leadership role in The First Edition, and following the success of 1969's Ruby, Don't Take Your Love to Town, the band gradually changed styles to a more country feel. The band broke up in the 75-76 season, and Kenny Rogers embarked on a long and successful solo career, which included several successful collaborations, including duets with singers Dolly Parton and Sheena Easton, and a songwriting partnership with Lionel Richie. Also, I like the duets with Kim Carnes and Dottie West. I'm sure there's more. And yeah, his partnership with Lionel Richie. Man, let me tell you something. Lady is a song written by Lionel Richie. One of my heroes, one of my R&B heroes, man. One of the first songs I ever danced to when I was a little kid during my parents throwing parties was Brick House by the Commodores, right? Lionel Richie, man, in his prime. But his rendition of Lady, as great as it is, pales in comparison to Kenny's version of it, you know. And you guys have heard me do this comparison often. Sean Connery might not be the original Bond, I don't think he is, but he owns the role, right? Kenny Rogers owns the song Lady. Even though Lionel's rendition is fantastic, even though he wrote it, this song, if I ever listen to Lady, belongs to Kenny Rogers. And it's one of those songs, one of those love songs, one of those ballads that's not sappy, that's not corny as hell. You know what I'm saying? Man, let me tell you. Yeah, and that is one of those great, great songs from Kenny that I've really come to love and embrace. You know, his rendition of Lady. Okay. Continue reading. Where was I, man? So, after some solo releases, including 1958's That Crazy Feeling, I already read that part, sorry. Let me just roll down to where I was. So, Ruby, Don't Take Your Love to Town. Okay, Dolly Parton, Sheena Easton, Lionel Richie. Okay, so his signature song, 1978's The Gambler, was a crossover hit that won him a Grammy Award in 1980 and was selected in 2018 for preservation in the National Recording Registry by the Library of Congress. He would develop the gambler persona into a character for a successful series of television films, starting with 1980's Emmy-nominated Kenny Rogers as the Gambler. Yeah, I gotta go back and watch that film again. I really enjoyed it. Rogers' album The Gambler and Kenny were featured in the About.com poll of the 200 most influential country albums ever. He was voted the favorite singer of all time in 1986, joint poll by readers of both USA Today and People. He received numerous awards such as the AMAs, Grammys, ACMs, and CMAs, as well as a Lifetime Achievement Award for a career spanning 6 decades in 2003. Later success included the 2006 album release Water and Bridges, an across-the-board hit that hit the top 5 in the Billboard Country Albums sales charts, also charting in the top 15 of the Billboard 200. The first single from the album, I Can't Unlove You, was also a sizable chart hit. Remaining a popular entertainer around the world, he continued to tour regularly until his retirement in 2017. Man, what an astounding accomplishment. 6-decade career in music. Relevant for 6 decades. Rogers also had a number of acting roles in movies and TV, most notably the title roles in The Gambler and the McShane series for the NBC mystery movie and the 1982 feature film Six Pack. He was a co-founder of the restaurant chain Kenny Rogers Roasters in collaboration with former Kentucky Fried Chicken CEO John Y. Brown Jr. Although the stores closed in the US, they are still a fixture in Asia. Okay, and death. On March 20th, 2020, Rogers died under hospice care at his home in Sandy Springs, Georgia. A representative for the singer said in a statement, "Due to the global COVID-19 pandemic, the family is planning a small private service with a public memorial planned for a later date." Okay, and this is where they're saying that more citation is required because they, as yet, don't have the information about the cause of his death. But I believe Al was mentioning to me that it was of natural causes. He was 81 and he had some health issues years preceding. So I think that amid the pandemic of COVID-19, it just happens to be coincidence. But we'll see for sure. I'll definitely stay apprised of that if it definitely had something to do with his passing. All right, man. Yeah, so that's the information. There's a lot more information here on his Wikipedia profile, but I could be reading all morning. Yeah. So, man, if you were to force me to, and here's the influence, here's the impact that this guy has had. If you were to force me to, I could sit down here and I can conjure up a number of songs. And again, I have not been brought up on a genre of country or anything of that sort. But where Kenny Rogers is concerned, you know, you've got The Gambler, of course. You've got Coward of the County. You've got She Believes in Me. You've got Islands in the Stream. You've got the duets with Kim Carnes and Sheena Easton. You've got Ruby, Love Will Turn You Around. So even I can sit here and at least come out with 10 of his songs. Maybe not his top 10, but I can pull 10 out of my hat. Yeah, probably even more. So that is the cultural impact that this person has had. He is one of those fixtures in your life. You're growing up, a part of the cultural experience of growing up that is like a kind of like chicken soup to the soul, kind of like a comfort food that's always there. And sometimes you don't, sometimes you take for granted the impact of a person like this always being around, but it's a part of your upbringing. It's like, you know, what's that saying about, it isn't just the parents that raises a child, it's the whole village, but now it's more expanded than that. It's the whole culture, you know, and he is a contributing factor to that culture of my upbringing. Yes, I have not been raised on the genre specific, but that is the impact that he's had on me. And right now, my dad is very, very upset. And my dad is an old blues man, but he also knows and recognizes the significance of Kenny Rogers. So, hey, sir, hats off to you. You've given us lots and lots of joy in your 6 decades of being in music. God bless you and take care. So, what am I gonna do here now going forward? If you have more Kenny Rogers requests, recommendations, well, you know, I'm not gonna do a whole floodload of, but definitely I will take the time to do a little bit more. He is that significant. I just wanted to say thank you for the our apologies ahead of time. And thank you for your patience and understanding. Whenever a great icon like this passes away, I have to pause and make some time and fit them in for a tribute. This pushes back my Unholy Trinity weekend again. I got the Led Zeppelin out, but this morning was slated for Deep Purple and Black Sabbath. So that's going to fall back a little bit. I got to bounce to work and then come back. Hopefully it isn't too late tonight, and then I will get to those. And then right after that, I also am pushing back by one day the Prophet Elijah's quad. So my complimentary quads are just pushing back a little bit. But we'll see. I think I'll do the Black Sabbath and Deep Purple, and I might not have enough time to get to the Prophet Elijah's quad today. So it'll probably be first thing tomorrow. Yeah, so apologies ahead of time for that. This is what happens, you know, I take the time, everything stops, and I immediately, as soon as I have time, do a tribute to one of our heroes who's passed. So, yeah, man, Kenny Rogers will always, always be one of those great cultural icons. And it doesn't matter what genre of music that you've been brought up in, he crosses borders and boundaries. Anyway, man, hey, I hope you enjoyed this. I really enjoyed it. Al, thank you very much for sending me the link and also notifying me. And yeah, man, whenever an icon like this passes, sometimes I'm caught up and I'm busy and I don't realize it. When Neil Peart passed, it took almost 16 hours for me to realize and know it. So as soon as you hear of one of these great heroes of music passing, send it to me right away. Send it to me on all my platforms. And even though I'm busy, I will have moments to come up for air, and then I'll see, and then I can kind of plan and get to a tribute reaction as soon as possible. And even if I might have to skip out of work a little bit early type of thing, you know. Anyway, so that's what these great icons of music mean to me. And it's very, very important to give them their due, man. So, Kenny Rogers, God bless you. Anyways, you guys have yourselves a good one. And I'll catch you in my next reaction, which will be... it will be Deep Purple. A full album reaction. Who Do We Think We Are? That's the name of the album. So, I'll see you in that reaction. Take care.